Hi, this is Sansan Mushi, and this is a pick a card reading on messages from my spirit guides. So you can go ahead and pick a reading 1, 2, or 3, and you can go to the description for the timestamp. Yeah, it's been a while, guys. Sorry about that. It's currently 1:45 a.m., but I'm definitely getting to it now. So this will be up by the morning, and it'll be really, really cool. So I'm excited to get these messages. Real quick, I'm going to be listening to a playlist on Spotify. It's called Cheyenne is a Music Goddess. That's the playlist name if you guys want to find it and learn what songs we're playing on this video. But yeah, I queued up some of them. I know, and I'll read to you guys the cue right now so then you'll know what songs are playing in this video. So, Waves Remix by Miguel and Casey Musgraves. Kiss the Boy by Kanan Lonsdale. Preach by Kanan Lonsdale. Only Human, Reflections, Vagabond. All by Mr. Wives. And then these ones are all by Alessia Cara. Girl Next Door, Not Today, and Nintendo Game. Yeah, and then that's all I have queued up. And then other songs will probably play because this video will probably go for a while. But we'll see how these messages go. The other announcement is this is a brand new deck that I got today, actually, from my mom. Woo! It's called the Mystical Manga Tarot. So, super exciting. It comes with a booklet, which I looked a little bit into it, and it's actually really, really cool. So, it's really in-depth. So, I might refer to it at one point, but I don't know. Definitely in the future, I'm going to read more on this book and learn more about, like, the author's meaning behind each of the cards. I mean, generally, it's going to be very similar, you know, but, like, they have a very interesting take. And at the end, they have the Journey of the Fool of the Major Arcana. So it starts, like, once upon a time, and it, like, tells the story all the way up to the world. Yeah, which is really, really cool. So I definitely want to read this later. But yeah, those are all my messages, and yeah, we're going to get started with reading number one. So let's see what card comes out. Oh, and I'm going to start the songs. Okay, so the Star. Wow. Alright, I know exactly what to do. I'm going to look at this. That wave. Give me a bit of time. So, the message I'm getting from this, sorry, if you guys want to look at the book, you can. You can pause to read it. But, yeah, basically, they have a divinatory meaning. I'll just read it. This card marks a period of rest and healing. The things your spirit needs to rejuvenate are close at hand, and for this time, however short or long, you can exhale and relax. During this time of calm, it is easier to find your true north. The next inhale brings inspiration and an eagerness to continue on, knowing things will be okay in the end. Also, ahead of time, if the music is distracting for you guys, sorry, I'm gonna keep listening to it. Yeah. And then the advice says, take it easy, relax and enjoy this respite? I don't know. Don't wait for the other shoe to drop. Do what you can to restore your mind, body, emotions, and spirit. Identify your North Star and learn to see it under any circumstances. So yeah, if you guys want to look into your North Star, that seems like good advice for reading number one. I do get this is a very, like, purifying time. I feel like drinking lots of water is a really good idea. In fact, I'm going to do that now. I feel like maybe not necessarily a bath, but anything that just feels like you're cleansing might be a really good idea. It could even be like getting some, like, I don't know, like jojoba oil and an essential oil, and then like lathering it and giving yourself like an oil body massage, kind of. That would be like really cool. This is what I'm getting. I know that was pretty specific. That's because what I'm doing. I'll actually show you guys. I have, like, right now I only have coconut oil, but I plan on getting jojoba oil. So yeah, I just mix like this oil with, I don't know, this lavender and this frankincense. So it's pretty nice. Right that way. And then let's see, this card, confidence, summon. So really the big thing right now that Spirit wants you to focus on is your confidence. I feel like you're afraid of a lot of things right now. Maybe there's a lot of what ifs going on. But like your message from Spirit guides is just saying, like, whatever your fear is, go ahead and just do it anyways. Kind of like how I'm doing this video, you know? I'm really tired and anxious, and I've kind of been going through a lot of things, but, like, I'm going to keep going through this with confidence, and I'm just going to trust that, you know, the messages will come out, and whoever they're, like, whoever's meant to hear them will hear them, and it'll be good for that. I know, like, my channel kind of, like, blew up quite a bit, so, like, I want to be, like, my top performance, but honestly, I'm just really tired, and this, like, is the time I'm going to do it, because if I don't do it now, I'm not going to do this reading, like, ever, and so when I get back in the groove of this, my readings will probably get better again over time, but for now, this is where it's at. So yeah, I feel like you really just gotta make some moves, make some decisions, take action. It's kind of relevant to my life. So you're, rest and build your confidence, because then you're going to notice, you're going to hear a certain call to action. You're going to feel guided to do something with that energy you've built up. And whatever the outcome, it's fine. It'll be worth it. Deal? This is real. Why not say something's on my mind if I feel love? Okay, let's see what this is. The Seven of Wands. Yeah, that's the point. It's supposed to be challenging. It's supposed to, it's supposed to feel scary. And then, literally, as you gain your confidence, you kind of just get through it. And then with your confidence, you come out victorious. I did see this at the bottom earlier, so I was like, yes. Six of Wands, victory. So, in this hearing, like, for those of you just reading number one, your message from Spirit Guides is you're scared to do something, but once you manifest enough confidence and feel really good about it and feel like it's the right time, go ahead and face those challenges with confidence, and all of the challenges will just blow away, and suddenly it'll feel like this, like a smooth sail. Alright, so that's reading number one. Cool. Reading number two, let's see what we got here. We have the Nine of Cups. Wow. So since this is a new deck, I'm basically just going to be reading from the book. Let's see what it has to say. In the old days, this was called the wish card. If it turned up in your reading, it meant that your wish would come true. Today, we don't go in so much for wishes being granted, preferring instead to earn our blessings through hard work. The truth probably lies in the middle ground. You've made some good choices, and the results are very pleasing to you. For this moment, at least, you feel like life is pretty darn good. The advice is to count your blessings, practice gratitude, and share your good fortune with others. Cool. So yeah, I just see that energy. I feel like you're in a really giving energy, feeling very, very, like, fulfilled, because you have all these wishes where you're like, no matter what happens, you're like fulfilling them. Like, kind of like giving away like a gift. If you give a gift to someone, like, there's no loss, there's just the outcome. You gave someone a gift, so you're counting your blessings. And it's like whatever you're doing right now, it's out of this energy of like feeling blessings. So literally whatever you face will be quite positive. Kind of like, yeah, that's basically the message I get. I'm going to start with this deck again. Gotta say the words you want to say right now. Love is a game, we just have to play online. Success! Yay! So, not only are you counting your blessings, but like literally, it's successfully happening. Your dreams are successfully coming true. So it's like, not just an outcome, it's a very positive outcome. So your spirit guides want to let you know a very positive outcome is headed your way. Probably soon. Wow. Okay, several cards wanted to leap out. Okay. Wow, the High Priestess. So with loyalty, the unknown, and hopes and fantasies, the hopes and fears, and your loyalty to balancing those both out, this will bring you on a successful journey, one where you fulfill your dreams, your wishes, your personal endeavors. Let's read what the High Priestess is. Alright. The meaning. The situation feels uncertain because what is important lies below the surface and doesn't necessarily seem logical. There are secrets afoot, muddying the waters. Only those well-versed in the rhythms of the universe will see what is really going on. Your advice is, one reason to work on understanding your inner life and being able to hear your inner voice is for times like these. The external situation isn't making much sense, so you really have to trust yourself. Circumstances will not help you decide what to do. Tap into your inner wisdom for the truest guidance in this case. So yeah, it's like you're either in a state of victory or you're reaching a state of victory, like success, well-being, like understanding, wishes, fulfillment, blessings, like awareness of your blessings, all that stuff. And a lot of your wishes and hopes and dreams coming true. Like, honestly, this is it's manifesting. But if you look at this through an external perspective, this reading won't make very much sense, perhaps, for some of you out there. But in a way, it should resonate for all, is that this is a success that is coming to you no matter, like, what. Like, whether you're seeing it in the physical world right now or not. It will make more sense. If you go within, you'll see it. And then externally, it will reveal itself. It's basically what I get. I'll pull a clarifier on that. A bit of a confirmation type of energy. Ace of Cups and Ace of Wands. So yeah, pretty damn good. Wow, a big change between water and fire. So I feel like these are two separate energies, as well as energies within you. You know, feeling very self-fulfilled and feeling like you have a fresh start or a brand new, like, idea of how this journey is gonna go. So, like, I'm just hearing a whole new journey. This is a renewal, a new beginning. A tower has to come down for this new beginning to build up. So with the Tower, Four of Cups, it looks like you have the energy to bring upon this tower moment and take up that opportunity and create the tower, but you've got to do it in order to get that fresh start. And of course, depending on how you create this tower moment will also impact in what shape or form this will manifest in the 3D world. So, wishing you luck on that. Aww, you just do you. Just be honest. Be whoever you are with this. Create that tower moment by being yourself. It's okay. Some would call it, like, triggering people. Like, It's okay if you trigger someone or if you get triggered. You're only human. I love this song. I absolutely love this one. I'm turning this one up. Only human. Only human. The Magician. Manifestation. Would you look at that? And Five of Swords. You gotta try again. Keep trying. What is this? The Ace of Wands again. Keep trying for that fresh start. Through your way of manifestation and through learning, of course. Especially through learning, through challenges and conflict. Push through those challenges. Spirit wants to say, you're actually reaching success here. Just by being who you are. So that's very positive. Awesome. Awesome. So that's reading number 2. Hope you guys enjoyed those messages from Spirit. Peace out. I might see you in this one. Alright. Reading number 3. Only human. Only human. Queen of Swords. Ooh. So, I'm gonna read from the book. I'm gonna have to turn on this volume because this song is so good. It's called Only Human by Mr. Wives. Alright, your advice. The meaning. The Queen of Swords has tasted both the joys and the sorrows of life. Rather than becoming bitter, she has crafted a useful philosophy. This makes her a wonderful resource when seeking solutions to sticky or complex problems. Her experiences have made her very discerning and able to see lies easily. She can make plans and devise strategies. Because she values logic, she can seem unemotional or detached. Alright, and then the advice. Take all the experiences of your life and turn them into useful and productive life lessons. Let challenging times make you stronger, but never cynical or cold. Wow, that's so relevant. I just want to say, for those of you who are reading number 3, readings 1, 2, and 3 all really created a whole sort of story for me in terms of like a step-by-step process to this whole journey. That from your spirit guides. So if you're curious, or if you feel that might resonate with you, you might want to listen through readings 1, 2, and 3, or maybe through 2 and 3, something like that. But basically what I'm getting is you've calculated the risks, you're very balanced right now between your emotions and your thoughts, and your intuition, like between what's known and what's not known, and you're pretty open to making your own decisions with this. And being who you're going to be, which is honest. You're going to probably choose the truth over anything in this sort of energy. So let's see what Spirit has to say about being in this sort of energy. I feel this is a very positive energy, especially from reading 2's segment. That's kind of like a breakthrough. This is a very positive energy to be in. This is kind of like what you've been working towards. Guided by spirit, yeah. Trust. So you're gonna probably communicate some things or make certain like major decisions really soon, and your spirit guides want to say that they are with you on this. They are definitely supporting that kind of energy. Choices as well as messages. Message. Wow, this is pretty specific, I would say. It's like, you have a choice. I feel like you're contemplating on reaching out through a message or waiting on receiving a message. So, I'll do both energies. This card will be for if you're waiting on a message. Spirit's kind of saying, this is in the bag, you'll get a message, and then I'm going to see what kind of message. I know it's going to vary because there's a lot of people this could resonate with, but let's see what the energy behind this is, the lessons with it. Four of Pentacles. This is about letting go of that. Let go of your hope and expectation of a message. Let go of the outcome. The outcome, while yes, there's enjoyable outcomes, it's overall it's overall positive. It's overall, like, you've already been working so much on this connection. So it's like, just let it go and let, like, pretty much just let it work itself out. Put in the efforts you're going to. And then if you want to give a message, victory. So I do get very positive energies from this in all aspects. So, yeah, just a lot of mirroring going on with you and another. Wheel of Fortune, fate, destiny, going with the flow. That's perfect. That's exactly the type of energy this feels like. By letting go, you go with the flow. So, it's okay to feel good about this, basically. I want to look into what's inside of your nine cups. So, I'm going to pull nine cards to see what are in those nine cups. Because I feel like that helps identify the situation a lot, to help you kind of get a clearer, to help you let this go. The hope and expectation part. Not necessarily hope, like, it's okay to have hope, you know, but, like, in terms of really the expectations or where your fears might be coming from, they literally might be a part of your hopes. So when I say let go of your hopes and expectations, I only mean the reflected version of it when it's like a fear. Because I get the feeling these nine cups, that there's something weird about them. And I've done this before. I've asked spirit, like, oh, the nine cups. I really like doing that. Because there's literally cups. I'm like, what's inside of these cups? And, like, they'd all be super, super positive. And then when I feel a funky vibe, usually it presents itself when I ask what all the nine cups are. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then 9. Alright. Let's see. So, yeah, right away. There's still something from before holding on to in one of your cups. This probably is like PTSD is how I would put it, but it doesn't have to be that extreme for everyone listening. Definitely the case for me, but Two of Swords, some indecisiveness, uncertainty. This just, yeah, it sounds a lot like some sort of deep issue like that. So again, for me, I'm resonating with this in terms of PTSD. But for you guys, it could just be like, oh, you know, I'm defensive and indecisive right now. Which, yeah, and then however extreme that is to you. Oh, wow, yeah, and kind of stop and go is in your hopes and dreams too, but maybe there's just an energy you remember. Let me see. Queen of Cups, yeah, it's an energy you remember. So, there's a lot of, like, connections maybe that are in your dreams that, like, didn't work out. So, like, I do feel like the past is actually much more deeply rooted into your nine cups. Wow. Love is in there. Very, very good. Three of Cups. Wow. Temperance. Yeah, I was about to wonder if the second half of this. So, yeah, this is really cycling out. Yeah, the end. This is cycling out. Sorry, let me move this camera. This really is cycling out some, like, death. This is more like a conveyor belt. So this is about releasing the old energy. You do have a lot of things that are going to help you with this energy. So yeah, let go of the expectation, let go of control, and live your life. Let the parts of you out that are full of fear and full of doubt, and full of, like, worry, I'm hearing it's time that you commit, but in your own way. You commit the way that you commit, basically. Everyone has a different commitment issue, basically, is what I'm getting here. So chances are, for those of you who chose reading number 3, if this is about love, usually, maybe you might feel like, oh, I'm so ready, but then, like, maybe you get kind of close to this person, then suddenly you're like, wait, I don't know if this is actually, like, what if it's a trick, or what if it's this or that, you know? Maybe a lot of fears come up. And so those are all the messages, but if you guys want to stick around and listen to this last song, It's called Girl Next Door by Alessia Cara. I swear, I'm gonna cry. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed those messages. Love and light. I'm really tired. That's such a good song. All right. So, if any of you guys just hung out, thanks for being here. I appreciate you all. It is 2:13 a.m. I will actually get some sleep now. I just really had to get this reading done because I really felt there were some messages from Spirit for you guys out there. That I've been wanting to share with you guys during this time. I'm probably going to do another pick a card reading, like the same exact topic, really soon. I'll get through a couple more suggested readings, and I'll do the same one again, because I really want to get a very good, like, message from my spirit guides reading in there. So yeah, sending lots of love and light, guys. Talk to you all soon. Peace out. Okay.